everybody. My name is Manny De Silva, and I'm the head fly tying instructor for the fly tying classes for the Western Mass Fly Fishermen. This is our logo, and this is a picture of my mentor, Joseph Berkowitz, of whom I took over the classes when he decided to retire out of it. And then what we're going to do, this is a quick video to bring my students back up to speed in case you forgot a procedure. This is the March Brown dry fly. I catch my thread a little bit behind the eye of the hook, establish a small thread base, and cut off my excess. Put that down, and half hitch. Next, we're going to tie in our wing for our March Brown. Again, I like to leave the material for the wing on the stem, lining up all the tips. Once I have that done, I like to clip it away from the stem of the feather. Measure my wing. It's about 1.5 to 2 times the size of the gap. Catch that on right on top of the hook shank. A couple of wraps. I'm going to keep it right on top. And once I get to wing position, I'm going to stand them straight up. Wrap nice and tight in front. Bring my thread behind the wing. And then before I go much further, I'm going to half hitch it to make sure I save my work. Then I'm just going to take my fine tip scissors. I'm going to cut it in stages to help form a tapered body. Take my thread and wrap it back to tail position. And execute a half hitch. I'm using a brown saddle hackle for the tail. Take my barbels. Peel them from the stem and wrapping them together to form my tail. Tail's going to be roughly the length of the body. Catch that on top of the hook shank. Then I'm going to take one quick wrap underneath the tail. I wrap back on top. Cut off my excess. All at a taper, and execute a half hitch. I'm going to re-energize a couple of inches of thread. I'm going to apply dry fly dubbing. Very, very small pinches to my thread. Take our little dubbing rope, form the body of the fly, just behind my wing. And half hitch. I'm now going to tie in my two dry fly hackles. This is going to be a mix of brown. We don't want a lot of webbing in our feathers, so we're going to cut it off where it starts to become large. And we're going to do the same thing with our grizzly feather. I'm going to prep it. In my fly tying classes, I like to trim on both sides of the stem. Oh, let me get my fine tip scissors. And I'm going to do the same thing to my brown hackle. Now that I have my two feathers prepared, I'm going to stack them good side up, line up the stems, and apply them to the top of the hook shank just behind the wing. Right on top of the hook shank. Stand my wing up, bring my thread right in front. I'm going to wrap all the way to the eye of the hook and wrap back. And execute a half hitch. Then take my hackle pliers. Taking the feather that's on top. Can we just pull it slightly forward just to fracture the outer core of the stem of the feather? Take a couple of wraps in back of the wing. We'll take a couple of wraps in front. And then we'll execute a half. A thread pinch. And that locks down our grizzly. Stand my thread straight up. Wrap to the eye of the hook and then wrap back. Execute a thread pinch, a half hitch. Okay, next item is our brown feather. Again, I'm going to take my hackle pliers. Grabbing the tip of the feather. Gentle pull. And this time as I wrap my brown feather, I'm going to oscillate it. So it passes through the other barbels of the grizzly hackle. I get to my wing, pull my wing back, and I'm going to wrap in front of the wing. And execute a thread pinch. Cutting off my excess stem. I'm now going to form the head of the fly. standing my thread straight up, I'm going to pull all the barbels back, wrap all the way to the eye, wrap back, and again just build up, wrapping, going back and forth and building up the head of my fly. Once I've accomplished that, execute 3 or 4 half hitches. I'm going to use my bodkin to help guide the knot so it doesn't. Again, we have a half hitch tool that's part of our dubbing spinner in our toolkits, and you can accomplish that with the same move with that particular tool by using it as a half hitch. Okay. Bring my scissors in close, clip. And then you can just glue up the head of the fly. Being so close to the eye of the hook, again, I like to transfer my glue to my needle. And then apply that to the head of the fly. And our March Brown nymph, our March Brown dry fly is done. I hope you enjoyed the video. Have a good day. Thank you.